Happy day, students. Welcome to Sun Academy Pallikarni, Class 8 Biology, Cell Structure and Function, Chapter 8. And as we all know that things around us are either living or non-living. Further, we all can recall that all living organisms carry out certain basic functions. And those functions are like respiration, absorption, digestion and excretion. And we all know that different set of organs perform the various function we have listed just now. And in this chapter, we are going to learn about the basic structural unit of an organ, which is the cell. And cells can be generally compared to the bricks, that is the building blocks of a building. As bricks are assembled to make a building, similarly cells are assembled to make the body of every organism. Now let us get into the chapter and discuss about it in detail. The cell, the building block of life. As we all know, the earth is inhabited with millions of different types of living organisms. All these organisms are made up of a microscopic units, and these microscopic units are called cell. Just like how there will be no walls without bricks, there will be no organism without cells, and hence it is coined as building blocks, because it is only the cell which is giving us the structural organization. And all the organisms need to perform a set of metabolic function to survive, like digestion, absorption, excretion, respiration, etc. And all the cells are capable of performing all these basic or essential life processes individually, that is on their own, and which clearly shows that cell can perform their own the life processes. And this means that life is not possible without cell, and hence it is called as the fundamental unit of life. So to summarize, as the cells are giving the structural organization, it is called as the building block of life. And as the cells are capable of performing the life processes on their own, it is called as the fundamental unit of life. Now let us enter into the discovery of cell. And as we all think, or as we may think, the discovery of cell was not a pre-planned one. It was a by chance or an accidental discovery. It was English scientist named Robert Hooke. When he was observing a cork under his primitive microscope, he noticed a large number of box-like or compartment-like structure in that, and that resembled the structures of a honeycomb. And he called these room-like structure as cells, and the word cell was derived from a Latin word called cellulae, which means little room. And from his observation, he also noted down that there was a dark spot in between each cell, or in between each little room. And this chance discovery made by him became a significant discovery in history of biology. Till to date, we are using the term cell, the building block of organism. And over the next 170 years, research led to the formation of cell theory. And it was first proposed by two great scientists, German botanist Matthias Jakob Sclerin and the German physiologist Theodor Schwann in 1838, and it was finally formalized by the German researcher Rudolf Virchow in 1858. And what does the cell theory states? The cell theory states that all living organisms are made up of cells, and the cells are capable of performing all the life processes individually. And it also stated that all new cells are formed only from a pre-existing cell. The visual aids used for viewing the cell is microscope. As we discussed in the earlier slide, the cells are microscopic unit, that is, they cannot be seen without an optical aid. And the optical aid that is used for viewing the cell are called microscopes. And there are two types of microscopes that are widely used in the laboratories. They are light microscope and compound microscopes. And what we are using in our laboratory is a compound microscope. So the one which we have handled in our lab is compound microscope. And let us have a brief discussion about that. I hope you all remember the microscope which we have used when we were doing the practical in last year in order to observe the budding yeast. And we know that there is a platform like structure which is called as stage, and we have metal clippers on them in order to fix in the slide in a perfect position and in a permanent position. And then we have knobs to adjust the distance between the lenses and the slide, and that much is fine. And when we are going to handle it, in the lab, we will get into much more details. Now, coming to types of cell with structural differences, based upon the components or based upon the structure that is making up the cells are divided into two types. It is prokaryotic cell and eukaryotic cell. And the word pro means primitive or lack of, and karyon means nucleus. And those cells which lack well-developed nucleus are called as prokaryotic cells, and the organisms that are made up of prokaryotic cells are called prokaryotes. And the word eu means true and karyons means nucleus, and those cells which have true nucleus are called as eukaryotic cells, and the organisms that are making up the eukaryote made up of eukaryotic cells are called as eukaryotes. So let us have a small comparison between prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Prokaryotes are generally small in size, whereas eukaryotes are larger in size. Prokaryotes, the organized nucleus is absent. Eukaryotes, organized nucleus is present. In prokaryotes, a single DNA molecule is present suspended in cytoplasm. Nucleolus is absent, that is, the DNA molecule, which is the genetic material, will not be surrounded by a nuclear membrane. Whereas in eukaryotes, organized nucleus is present with nuclear envelope and nucleolus is present and several DNA molecules are present inside the nuclear envelope. And in prokaryotes, several membrane bound cell organelles are absent, whereas eukaryotes do have membrane bound cell organelles. Prokaryotes, vacuoles are absent, whereas eukaryotes do have vacuoles. In prokaryotes, mitosis is absent, whereas in eukaryotes, mitosis is present. Coming to prokaryotes, examples are bacteria, cyanobacteria or blue-green algae. Coming to eukaryotes, it is plants, animals, fungi, etc. Now let us discuss about the difference in organisms based upon the number of cells, shape and size. Millions of living organisms have cells with different shape and size. Their organs also vary in shape, size and number of cells. Human body generally has trillions of cells which vary in different size and shapes. Different group of cells perform a variety of functions. Organisms made up of more than one cell are called multicellular organism. An organism with billions of cells starts life as a single fertilized egg cell. The fertilized egg cell multiplies by dividing processes and number of cells increase for development. The single-celled organisms are made up of single cells called unicellular organism. A single-celled organism performs all the necessary function that multicellular organisms perform. So, coming to the classification of organisms based upon the number of cells that are making up them, it is classified into unicellular organism and multicellular organism. Organism that only have a single cell, multicellular organism that consists of many cells. Examples for unicellular are amoeba, bacteria, paramecium, and examples of multicellular are plants and animals. So, in the same slide, you can see a detailed comparison between unicellular and multicellular. Unicellular, single cell. Multicellular, many cell. Unicellular, all the life process is being performed by a single cell. Multicellular, cells have different cells in order to perform different life processes. Unicellular cannot be divided into cells. They are also called acellular organism. Multicellular, different shapes and of cells are present and they are aggregated or grouped together to form tissues. So in unicellular, cell division, that is the division of labor, is absent, whereas in multicellular, division of labor is seen inside the cell. And multicellular tissues form organs and organ give rise to organ system and that performs special functions. Examples of unicellular are amoeba and paramecium, and for multicellular it's plants, animals and fungi.